I built this room for you. This house. You do love me, don't you? Don't you? Good. Then fulfill that love or we both die. Shall we dance?
Dance in the dark. Dancing in the dark, and it soon ends. We're waltzing in the wonder of why we're here. Time is why we're here. I have you, love. And we can face the music together.
Open up, Tyler. I've got the law with me. It's over, damn you. I've got a court order. This house is mine.
Brighten up the night. I have you, love, and we can face the music together. Dancing in the dark.
Unfortunate times, Mr. Cates. Damn depression.
Plenty of these swells have taken a fall since the crash. No offense, sir. I'll try a shoulder on it.
This was once a show place. He's been selling everything off, bit by bit. Come with me.
Open up, Tyler. I know you're in there.
Break it.
Oh, my God.
Look here.
Oh.
Six antique chairs. One gold frame mirror. Three silver candelabras. Hey, check this out. We also get a 1961 Cadillac hearse.
Right. Your great uncle Harry Cates turned the place into a funeral home for a time.
Oh, great.
All day long, just sit around the house. Watch.
Oh, still meow. Look at all these mansions.
Ours is just as big.
Maybe a little bit older.
According to the probate report, it was built in 1926.
LA, where?
Hey, Scott, there's our school. It's only a few blocks from the house. You could just walk there. Maybe you could drive the hearse.
Yeah, it'd be styling. Pull up to campus in a hearse? What do you think, Dad?
Theater arts. I still don't see what you want with that stupid curriculum.
It gave me a scholarship.
Yeah, and one in engineering.
I hope it's not on this block.
We're almost there, kids. Meet Mom.
Oh. Come on now, give it a chance. The whole area is under urban renewal. It's starting to redevelop.
Is it safe? I understand they have a very strong neighborhood watch program.
Yeah, the neighbors watch you get mugged.
That's not true.
She's right. Most of them participate.
Keep you up with the roosters. Now get the fuck out of here.
Welcome to the neighborhood.
Yeah. Do you got company?
Excuse me. Hate to break up your little party, but we're moving in.
Hey, Crip. These folks are moving in.
Get the shotgun out of the car.
Dad, no guns.
Damn it, Scotty, do as I say.
Okay, let's move it. Warning yourself. Stay away from these folks, or you're gonna do another 6 months. She's not your type, Crip. She hasn't murdered anybody yet. Now get the hell out of here. Folks, really gonna move into the old Tyler place?
Tyler place? My uncle, Harry Cates, owned this place for 50 years.
Yeah, well, you know, some names just kind of stick.
Yeah, it has to do with some old actor. Nobody's wanted to live in this place.
A lot of nonsense, really. You know, we haven't heard anything for years.
Well, my family can take care of themselves.
Well, that's good, because we've got our hands full around here.
Yeah, but don't hesitate to call us, okay?
That was reassuring.
See, the decorators were here.
Damn. I thought I told the city to turn on the electricity. Did you mail the check?
I mailed it in. There was a problem at the bank.
I'll get a flashlight.
To Myrna, eternal love.
I couldn't find the... Wow.
Anything wrong?
No.
Well, I'm going out for some food. You got any preference?
Pizza?
How'd I know you'd say that?
This is unreal. Now they want to include this inheritance in the bankruptcy. We're going to have to go back for the court hearing.
Then that's what we'll do. The cord on this blanket's all frayed. Darn it. It would have felt so good tonight, too.
Sylvia, no electricity.
Future reference.
Can't believe how badly I failed all of you. Having to live in this monstrosity.
It's gonna work out. Don't worry, Harry.
You're the best.
Anybody home? Thank you. Tyler. How about that? I don't know. I think we're gonna like it here.
I think so too. It's so pretty.
When we get the house fixed up, you and your dad will let us have a party.
Yeah. Hey, Sol, did you get that theatrical makeup course?
Uh-huh. You gotta see the special makeup effects they can do down there. It's wild.
So, was it locked?
I don't know. It must have been jammed. It's really bizarre. There's this stage setting up there from the 1930s.
Sounds demented. Kind of ranks up there with biology.
Biology?
We have to dissect frogs. But it's okay. We chloroform them first.
Ah. Oh.
Hey, watch out.
Hey, want to play? Need a fourth?
The old knee's acting up. You can take my place.
I'll play for 10 minutes.
How you doing, Petie?
Scott.
Okay, all right. Come on, you ready? Here you go. Watch it.
Ball, please. Please. I like that. Very polite.
Especially for some jambone motherfucker.
Why don't you just give us the ball?
What do you think, Melvin?
Should I give it to him?
Sure, give it to him.
Leave him alone!
That's enough!
Don't tell her to.
You know, it's only gonna get worse. Have you ever considered moving out? Let's not tell Mom and Dad about this, all right? They got enough problems.
Okay. Company said they fixed them, but I can't get them on. Scott, there's an old fuse box in the cellar. Do you think you could?
I'll check it out.
Take the flashlight. Be careful.
I will.
We better hurry up in case he can't get the lights fixed. should be home soon. Imagine working for someone after owning your own company for all these years. What's that? I don't know. Probably just some old pipes. It's coming from behind here. What's this for? I don't know. I didn't even notice it.
Thing's pretty cool, huh? A little dumbwaiter. What's the matter? Didn't the fuse work?
Haven't we got enough problems without you scaring the hell out of us?
I'm sorry. It won't happen again.
Scott, are you on the third floor?
Yeah, Dad.
It's almost midnight. You've been spending a lot of time up there.
There's some pretty interesting stuff up here.
I thought maybe you were stashing abroad.
Not quite. I'll be down in a minute.
Some dream. Get you all tangled up like that.
It wasn't a dream. I felt the presence in the room.
Damn it, Scott, you're doing it again.
You're right. You're right. I guess it was just a dream.
All right, come on, let's get you back to bed. Come on, honey.
I'll keep going, son. Good night, son.
Good night.
Good night. Good night.
Give that motorcycle back to that mutant.
You bet. I might be a little stupid, but I'm not crazy.
Great, I'll owe you one.
Forget it. Hey, I need to look something up. How can I get some help around here?
Hey, I'm the man.
Oh, yeah?
Well, unless the Lakers make me a better offer. Now, what do you need?
A stage actor from the 1930s, Tyler Walker.
Oh, that's easy. You know, a lot of theater art students do reports on him. That dude lived over there on Marlowe.
So I hear.
You know, the word is that old Tyler place is, spooked.
Yeah?
Okay, come on, I'll show you the files. Yeah, I heard some family just moved in there.
Really?
Yeah. Must be the Adams family.
Here you go.
All right, now this is a reference only. I had some other files on him. Some creep came up here and stole them.
Oh, this is great, thanks.
Sure.
Hey, let's play hoops again sometime.
Hey, anytime. Where'd you say you lived at?
2509 Marlowe. In a macabre finish reminiscent of his many stage roles, renowned character actor Tyler Walker took his life. Despondent over the marriage of Myrna Robbins, his leading lady for many years, to Harry Cates. Oh my God. So Tyler's lover was our great aunt Myrna Cates. She appeared in most of his plays until she married Uncle Harry. It was even rumored that she and Tyler had an illegitimate child together.
Spicy.
What do you think? A little family resemblance?
Not really. Well, I don't know. Maybe.
No.
Kate's got real cute.
I shouldn't have shown you that picture. It's okay, don't worry.
Sure. It's not safe in the streets. And now it's not even safe in this house. Meow? Meow? Is that you?
Time for romance, Romeo. Take her. Good thing you woke up.
We have to have positive identification. But I know who they are. You said they were wearing masks. It doesn't matter. You drew these for memory? That's a wonderful talent. But it's nothing that we can use in court. I'm sorry.
That's it?
Well, we'll speak to them, of course, but we have nothing to go on.
Sure, speak to him, by all means.
I know this must make you angry, but we
You're damn right I'm angry. If this is all the police have to offer, believe me, I'll protect my family any damn way I see fit. Here you go, Scott. Give it a try.
No, thanks.
Come on, with a little practice, you could be an expert with this.
Dad, guns get people killed, remember?
Not that pea shooter. Now, here's some serious artillery. Here you go.
No, really. I'm trying to quit.
How the hell do you expect to defend yourself?
I'll manage.
And Robin? The hell kind of kid did I raise? What are you, chicken shit? You're just plain stupid. Looking good, Rambo.
Heard it was open season on Japanese imports.
Look, Scotty, that court date's in 4 weeks. Do me a favor, will you? Promise me you'll keep this shotgun by your bed while we're back in Boulder.
Start this time, I can feel it.
Forget it, that old thing's gone in the way of the dinosaurs.
Come on, baby. Shit.
So much for the pep talk.
We could use a car when Mom and Dad are gone.
Yeah, right. A car. What's this?
An old circulating pump. I used it to suck a lot of the crap and condensation out of the gas tank.
Wasting your time. I thought you were gonna build me a kiln so I could fire up some of these masterpieces of mine.
I will, as soon as I get this started. There's nothing to worry about. It's been 2 months since anything happened. Besides, I have midterms.
And I get carsick.
It's just that we've got to get to that hearing. We can't let them take everything.
Don't worry.
Give your mom a kiss. Mwah. I love you.
I love you too.
Good luck up there.
Thanks. Now you think about what I said.
I will.
All right, bye.
Count Dracula desires the pleasure of your company on the trip to the Crip.
Nice accent, Count.
Just call me Dracky. You ride in the place of honor? Sealed inside, of course, for your maximum comfort.
God, you are really sick.
Sick? People are dying to get inside these things. Didn't you know that? You drive down near the beach, it'll be great in this hearse.
Yeah.
Shit. Roll your window up.
Come on, kids. Don't you want to be friendly?
Why don't you just leave us alone?
We come here to be nice. To forgive and forget, and what do?
Get the hell out of here.
Lighten up.
We're just being playful. Playful as kittens.
Open up or we'll drag your asses out of there.
That should hold him for a while. Good drive.
Fancy footwork.
Hey, maybe I should get you out of the house, at least till Mom and Dad get home.
No, damn it. They're not gonna push us out. We'll manage. He's fine. We locked all the doors. I know, 911. Okay, well, I'll talk to you tomorrow. Don't worry, we'll be fine. I love you too. Bye.
How are they doing?
Fine. They're gonna stay another week.
Did they go to court yet?
She's nothing. She's just a little girl. Okay, okay.
long a nap.
Silk said to wait.
Fuck Silk!
Crip's inside. He's been gone 2 hours.
So? He's probably inside holding his Sam's.
No, he's in trouble.
Somebody better go in.
Excellent idea, Melvin. Why don't you go?
Don't you fucking tell me what to do. What kind of shit is this? Aw, man, that ain't no fucking ghost.
My sentiments exactly. Stony, let's go.
I'm coming.
So what are you waiting for? An engraved invitation?
I'll check out the basement. at you?
Nice piece of artwork.
The nose is a little off.
Here, take it. I'll get rid of her.
I can't believe it really worked. I mean, it worked. I think you overdid it with the blood. Scott, come on, we gotta hurry.
Just a second.
We're running out of chloroform.
He will not be waking up for a while.
What about the ketchup?
I got something that I think will be a little better.
Oh, what is that?
It's from the special effects lab at school.
Oh, it's so gross.
A little glue on the stomach to hold it? Don't touch it.
Well, come on, Scott, hurry.
I got one finishing touch, wait. Silk!
Sworn they'd all left.
I'm gonna go get the hearse. Let's get them loaded.
I think we already did.
My cousin was in Beverly Hills. He looking through the trash, he found a brand new golf club and brand new golf bag in the trash. Believe that? Brand new fucking clothes. Well, I don't understand it, man, because all I ever see when I look around is nasty old smelly shit. Nasty old shit.
Was that a penisaurus? What are you doing? Beating it off? Melvin's dead. Someone cut off his head.
Shut the fuck up! Nobody is dead. Nobody but those two kids.
Then where's Melvin?
Tracking your reputation.
Who are you talking to?
No one. Watch out for Aunt Myrna.
Aunt Myrna? What are you talking about?
Tyler used to pretend that mannequin was Aunt Myrna.
Come on, Scott.
I'm serious. In a fit of passion, he signed the deed to this house over to her. And then she went and married Uncle Harry.
Poor Tyler. No wonder he looks so mean.
If it's any consolation, Aunt Myrna died in a Swiss sanitarium about a year ago. She never got over the death of her first love.
Have you guys got any idea what you've done?
We thought we could scare him off.
This ain't Dubuque, Iowa, wherever you're from.
Colorado. We'll be fine.
You guys just don't get it, do you?
Don't answer it.
Yeah.
Pizza's here.
We didn't order one.
2509 Marlowe?
That's our address, but we didn't order any pizza.
Ah, shit. These fraternity jerks call in pizza orders and they think it's funny.
Sorry, bud.
This is my last run of the night. This stuff's just gonna end up in the garbage. How about $5?
Want some pizza?
No.
It's a large pepperoni with mushrooms and a free quart of Coke. I mean, you can't beat that.
What do you think?
Hey, sounds good to me, but I got a jam.
Sure, we'll take it. It smells good. The box is still warm.
Looks good to me. Appreciate it.
Pack of savages out there ready to kill, and you develop a taste for pizza?
Thanks for the warning.
Good night, Petie.
Good night, Rob.
See ya.
See ya.
Petey's right. You better keep that shotgun with you all the time.
It's right over there.
Is it loaded?
No. I'll do it.
Now. I'm gonna double check all the doors and the windows. Oh, will you wait up for Mom's call?
No problem. Okay. You'll be all right, don't worry. Sure you don't want any pizza?
It's been a long weekend.
Okay. Good night.
And keep your mouth shut. Now get out of here.
You see what I see?
It's gonna ruin it.
Dead.
Yeah?
Well, you gotta choose your friends wisely.
Where's my sister? You heard me. Where is she?
Ta-da.
You're sick. All of you.
Handsome couple. Don't you think? Let her go or he dies. I mean it!
My bet is you don't have the ball.
Don't make me do it. Let her go or I'll blow his fucking head off. I swear I'll do it.
A regular hero.
All right, let's see how you hold up on the other end.
Bill!
That's enough.
Please, don't hurt him. I'll do anything you want.
Leave him alone.
What?
The lady said, don't hurt him.
All right. I won't hurt him.
Robin, no.
Robin, no!
I lied.
You think we're that stupid?
That's enough. You made your point.
Mind your own business. Besides, the fun's just begun.
I ain't gonna be a part of this. It's cute.
Come on, let's go upstairs.
2 beers. We'll be up there longer than that.
Here you go, Melvin. She's more your speed.
Brain dead.
You know, that was a bad move, Preppy. Thinking you could fake us out with that ghost bullshit? Nobody fucks with us.
Another one of your fucking stunts!
No. I swear.
Where are the lights?
It must have blown a fuse. In the basement.
You want to go check it out?
This is for you. Put it on. They're yours. They always were. We need a clip. Your hair.
like all of a sudden cold. Hey, what say we turn this on? We get nice and toasty.
Hey, baby, we don't need no extra heat. This place gives me the creeps. Did you hear that noise? It came from downstairs. Maybe we should check it out.
Why don't you do that?
I'm gonna go find Stony. Watch him.
This room waiting for you. You love me, don't you? Don't you? Good. Now fulfill that love, or we both die.
Thank you.
That's the Tyler place.
Let's roll, huh?
Robin. My sister, come on. Open up, you bastard! Okay?
I had this dream.
It's all over now.
It was an awful, awful dream.
Everything's gonna be okay.
It's a good thing they're all dead.
Oh, Harry, please.
What? Saves me the trouble.
I still don't understand how it happened.
Old Tyler's ghost, man.
The police found a reasonable explanation for all the deaths.
All at once?
Sure, with those psychos hopped up on drugs and booze, hell, anything could have happened. Come on now, take a little credit. Cops talked about you two like you were heroes.
Petie was the only hero.
Is this all of it?
Yeah.
Good. I don't want any reminders.
I'm sorry.
It wasn't your doing.
Crip never had no family life. I kind of kept him company. He was always drawn to this place. I never knew why. I think I do now. Cops had me go through his family stuff.
Yeah?
His old man ran off a long time ago, but I remember Crip saying that his father was adopted.
Born to Myrna Robbins the 16th day of December, 1934. That would make Crip's father.
That's right. Crip's father was
Tyler's illegitimate son.
I kind of miss old Tyler. 2 months and not a peep. I guess he's found peace.
I don't want to talk about it.
Hey, I need that.
So do I. Beauty before safety.
You don't believe any of it?
Not a bit. Just because some guy gets jilted, he decides to hang around and haunt people for a few decades? No way.
This time it was a dream, I promise. Wanna go downstairs and get something to eat?
Okay.
Come on. You know, I've been thinking about it. There was a logical reason for each of those deaths.
You're right, Scott. There's always an explanation.
Now you're talking.
Ha 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 ha